You needed some coins to build that dream team you guys have always wanted, make sure to head on over to my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They have the cheapest, the quickest, and most reliable coins on the market right now. Head on over to Buy Madden Coins and use code Poodle at checkout for 20% off your order. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, I'm going to be going over what to expect and kind of what you should be looking for with Series 4. Now, if you guys already know, Series 4 is coming within the next week or so. It has been quite a while since Series 3. I mean, time flies, right? It depends. If your guy doesn't play for a while, it probably feels like it doesn't, but when you play every day with these making videos, the time feels like it barely flies, and then before you know it, we're in the next series. The time's going pretty quick this year when it comes to Madden for me, and if you guys don't know, series are pretty much separated by about a month, give or take, right? Sometimes a little more, a little bit less, but it's usually about a month and a week, give or take. So it is December, and we'll be going Series 4. So the first series, obviously, was the first day it dropped, which was in July 25th, just about, August 30th, I mean, July 30th, and then the next one was in September the first week, then October the first week, November, that was like the third, and now we're going to December for the fourth. Now, quite a few things come with the series update. Series updates, in my opinion, are kind of like a shot of life into Madden, especially when it's in a dead time, but luckily for us, Madden's never been less dead. It's been nice. We have the Harvest, the Blitz, and now we're going right into Christmas, and Christmas is going to come fast, so Series 4 might get washed out a little bit by Christmas, which is why I want to get over all of it, guys. But quickly, before we get into the video, I have a few things to go over real quick. First things first, it is the 25 days of Poodmas, guys, so make sure you are entering to win these giveaways. The winner for yesterday will be announced in a video today, so just stay tuned for that. Now, if you guys already know, all you gotta do to enter is hit the like button, comment down below the secret word you'll hear throughout the video, and make sure to hit that subscribe button. Like I said, I wasn't gonna do sub to win, but I realized that a bunch of people who were, you know, not on the channel were just coming here just for giveaway strictly. And the thing with that is that I want to give back to people who watch me. That's kind of the point of this whole Christmas giveaway thing. And I feel like I'm just going to start giving away to randoms who just pop up on my search feed and just watch me. So I want to make sure that I'm giving it back to the fam. So make sure you guys are subbed. Make sure you guys like and comment. And by the way, real quick shout out to the Barker Boys, guys. Just starting up in the Madden community. A dad and I believe his kids. He just wants to... He wants to make it in the Madden world, guys, and I understand what it feels like to start from nowhere in Madden and want some kind of support, because I was just there a few months ago starting from nothing, and you know, not a lot of people were willing to help, so I understand, guys. Shout out to the Barker Boys. Look them up, Barker Boys Madden. Hit them and give them a sub. Show some support, guys. Now let's get into this video. So first things first, I got my notepad out and ready. Make sure to stay tuned for the secret word, by the way. That will be some point throughout this video. So Series 4, what's the first thing we expect with Series 4? First off, new trophies. We currently have Series 3 trophies. The color seems to change. I'm pretty sure the color changes every series. So Series 4 is coming soon. Sadly, I did not really get too many Series 3 trophies. I have not had much time to actually play the game. I made a lot of videos, made a lot of coins, but I have not had time to actually go ahead and play online to really get my trophies up. But the trophies will be switching now. First things first, when Series 4 trophies come, your trophy limit will be split in half. So if I have 480, I will end up with 240. So what I want to recommend here is you might want to use the trophies you have. Let's say you have 2,000 trophies saved up, you will lose 1,000. So maybe it would be in your best interest just to use it all on John Madden collectibles and build up next series. Unless you have 2,000 and you just want to get the Nat Master, which will be about 1,000, you can just save it and you'll have it instantly. That's all up to you. So that really depends on what you want and what you usually use your trophies for. Me personally, I like to use my trophies for John Madden because the Master seems to have some deficiencies every single time that I'm not really a fan of, like McCourty not being able to hit, which was an efficiency for free safety that I'm kind of tired of having, especially in a run-heavy game. Although I really wanted that McCourty, I was kind of skewered against not doing it. Now, next thing is going to be the new Master. So the new Master, if you guys know what I'm talking about, just to go wrap it up, is competitive currency. Over here, it is the Devin McCourty right here. Series 3 competitive Master and the Nat Series 3 competitive Master. Typically, if you manage to get trophies super quick and you're a grinder and you play all day, maybe take the auctionable one because you can't sell that thing for over a million coins in the first few weeks, like the first week or so. Now, me, I typically don't play enough, so I like to go with the Nat Series 3 Competitive Master if I do take it because it's Nat, costs me half the price, and I can use the rest on the John Madden collectible. So, there will be a new one. So, the first one, I believe, was Von Miller 91, or was it 92? It was 91. Then it was Melvin Gordon, I believe, was he a 93, and then there was Devin Gordon 94. So, the next one's going to be probably 95. I don't know who they'll give us. We have so far a halfback, a outside linebacker, and a free safety. We could see a wide receiver, we could see a defensive lineman, or we could even see an offensive lineman. I'd personally be fine with an offensive lineman. I would love that. I'd actually probably take that. That'd be a solid add to the team. See, I just don't want a position where like I have to really make cuts. Like free safety was hard because I have Dawkins. Halfback, we have so many options. And then outside linebacker was actually solid. Von Miller was a guy where I was a good position where I needed a guy like that, and that was perfect. Now, the other thing is, I mean, I personally prefer to go for the John Madden collectibles, unless we get a banger at Nat for Series 4. But definitely get your Madden collectibles. If you guys don't already know, when you get to tier 5 of John Madden, you do get to put athleticism boost on your team, which is huge. Right now, the first two are just John Madden boost, and then the second two are more John Madden boost. You can get like John Madden passing two, John Madden rushing two. The fifth one, I believe, is the athleticism boost, which means John Madden plus one speed. So that means you can add speed to your whole team, which is huge. You can get every guy up plus one speed on your entire roster. So that's the one I'm aiming for, which is why I'm either going to grind out really hard this week and get a ton of trophies, or I'm just going to take the L, keep half my trophies, and then next series grind out, because I definitely need these Madden collectibles. I need 2,000 trophies, and I'm really far behind. I have to get back on my seasons grind, which I have. I'm undefeated in my seasons right now. I got to get into the playoffs, but I did demote a lot trying to get gameplays for you guys, so I got to get back up so I can get the good rewards. Next is going to be the new objective. Your word for today is candy cane. Comment down below, like the video, hit that subscribe button to be entered. Massive part of the series grind that I'm going to mention real quick. It's probably self-explanatory at this point. Two things are going to be the torry holt upgrade tokens. As you guys do know, pretty much every level of grind we typically get a torry holt upgrade token. We'll probably get a captain upgrade token through solos also for Ryan Shazier or whoever you guys have, or that'll be for the Christmas promo, either or. But our torry holt should be getting an upgrade. You'll probably end up going to like a natural 95, 96 without being, you know, chemmed and powered up. As well as we will be probably getting a new level cap. So right now I think it's level 70. We might only get 5, but we could get 10. The trend this year has been 10. So we might go up to 80, but it also could just be 75. But I think we'll go to 80 this time. And with a new level up grind, that means there will be new level up packs, new level up quick sell packs. There will be level up quick sells and a final pack, such as like a full legend, a full redux, a full NFL 100, a lot of cool things. So just gonna throw that in there real quick. You guys probably already know that already, but that was a big part of this, which is kind of how a lot of us get our initial trophies. Pretty much the first 1,000 trophies of a series are super easy. To get the first 1,000 trophies, this is how you just play the game, go up to series progression, go to series through multiplayer wins. Look, I've only won 20 games. That's how you know I barely played the series. But usually I end up somewhere in like the 200 range. Pretty much this is the easiest way to get trophies, because as you guys can see, you get 10, 30, 30, 30, 30, 60, 60, 60, 120, 120, 120, 120, 120. So this amounts to, I believe, close to 1,000, if not over, a little bit under. But that's typically how you get your first 1,000. You just play those, very simple to get. And then you also get your seasons wins trophies, you get your head-to-head trophies, you get your weekend league trophies, your solo battles trophies. So it all adds up. Now, obviously, I haven't played a lot, but this is going to reset. So for all you guys who are grinders and you're almost done with this, this will be resetting for you guys in the short future when we do get series 4. So don't worry, that will reset and you can get your whole grind going again, which is cool, because sometimes once you get your 200 wins, there's less to play for. At least you know you have that whole thing to play for again with the trophies coming. And then the next thing I want to talk about is the Gauntlet Master. Now, to show you guys what I'm talking about, I don't know if you guys have been keeping track of this or if you've even played Madden long enough to know about this. The Gauntlet Master, if you come over here, the Gauntlet Exchange. So, they don't have the sets here yet, but if you guys already know, the Gauntlet last year or in years past has been, there's been multiple sets of Gauntlet, or there's been a set of Gauntlet, and then they give us a Gauntlet Master set of solos, where pretty much you play it and you get one of those Gauntlet players at a very high overall. So, to show you guys the rewards that are possible, let's go over to play. Let's come over to the Gauntlet. I'm just going to find where that is. All the way down here, the Gauntlet one. So we currently don't have any more, but we have the rookie, the veteran, and the legend. So if you go to the end, I believe, is it the last one that guarantees it to you, or is it milestones? So milestones, if you look at the bottom, gives us a Gauntlet one expert token. Now you're gonna want to play all your solos and get this expert token at some point. Obviously you gotta play, I think a lot of them on like 5 stars to get them. So I'd recommend you go back and you get these done. You want to have that done because there's going to come a point in a certain series, I don't know if it's gonna be the next one or anything, but it will come to a point where you gotta play the whole thing to get your tokens. Now same thing with Journey, the Journey completion token. You want to be playing these solos to get your tokens because I'm pretty sure all these will amount to be put into a set to get yourself a free amazing player. Now, I don't know when they will finally drop that. Could it be the next one? Typically, they've had 6 different sets of gauntlets, and then we have to play them all, and then we get a player. So, if you guys already know, we have Juju Smith, we have Devin White, Ed Oliver, Leonard Fournette, and I forget the other one. But the way that would work is that pretty much those guys were all, what, like 89, 90 overalls, whatever they were. So, the way it would work now is when the Gauntlet Master set comes out, you exchange all your tokens. Well, first off, there'd be a new series. You have to play the new set of solo series, play them all, and then you get another token, you combine them, and you put them into a master set that will be in the sets. And you'll be able to usually pick one of those guys at a very high overall. They'll be like 95 overalls, which is why those guys don't go into power-ups, if you guys remember. They're not power-upable because you're waiting for their full form. So let's say you're going to put the thing in, you'll be able to choose from a 95 Juju Smith, a 95 Fournette, a 95 Ed Oliver, a 95 Devin White. Devin White's going to be beastly if they give us a 95 version of him. So that's going to come soon. So I recommend you guys just start getting these solos done just like precautionarily, just to have them done, because nothing's going to suck more than when it comes out and you're like, oh God, I got to get 100 more stars on here, 100 stars on here. Just get them all done. And same thing with Journey. We'll probably be able to get a Journey Master at some point, considering they do give us that Journey one completion token, unless they put them all together. That could be possible too. They put the Journey Gauntlet and everything together. They've never done that before, I don't think, but they still could. And then next, like I said, the John Madden collectibles is something I want to cover. I recommend that's the first thing you guys go for as soon as possible, because you're gonna fall behind. You probably realize that a lot of people probably have similar teams to you, but the team feel better. It's called the John Madden. John Madden is the reason that my Lamar Jackson, when you guys used to ask me, like, why is your Lamar 91? The reason is Lamar Jackson. I mean, John Madden. I get a lot of passing boost. Look, he looks like a very adequate quarterback with speed because of the John Madden passing boost. I also have John Madden rushing, which makes Barry Sanders pretty insane too. I'd recommend that you guys get the John Madden done, because that is a huge boost to your team. And then obviously there's going to be increased pack odds, which is, don't take it for what it is. It's not like, wow, they're going to be a lot better. But if you guys come over to, let's say, a gold pack, which is all the way somewhere over here. Let's go to like a gridiron pack. What's the base pack? Get a gold, these are the ratios right here, let's say. So the chance of getting an 80 plus is 17%. So pretty much the way this would work now is that when the next series comes out, the 72s are still going to be 100, the 75s might be like a little bit less, and now the 80 pluses might be 25. They'll increase the odds a little bit because they know after every series pretty much is like, okay, like a lot more better cards are in the game. We're still letting them pull cards down here. Let's kick this up a little bit so at least the baseline floor level matches. It's always going to be the same in theory because, right, let's say right now 80s are 17% and 80s used to go for 10K. Now 80s go for, let's say, 6K. So they're going to make it so you can get 80s easier, but they only go for as much as they would have went in ratio as before. So now you're going to be pulling 82s, but the 82s go for 10K. So it works out about the same way, but it does give you a better chance of pulling better cards. Just something I thought I'd mention because I thought you guys would be interested. But I think that does wrap up pretty much everything for Series 4 you guys want to be worried about. There could be more solos. There could be the Gauntlet Master. That could be next series. But this will come at a weird time because it is going to be right around the Christmas promo. So probably going to be overshadowed, but still a good thing to know and go ahead and get things done. If you haven't finished all your games yet, guys, I recommend you do that. Because what if you're like 195 games left, done, and you have 5 games left for your final 120 trophies? You might want to get that done because nothing's going to suck more than getting all the way up there and not getting your final reward. So I think that wraps up everything. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like I said, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, turn that notification bell, come join the family. Don't forget to type down below the secret word and your console. And hit that subscribe button, like the video to enter the giveaway. That's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'm out. See you guys next video. Peace.